It's been an uphill battle all along, and finally 4BC has pulled the plug on Jamie Dunn. He says he was sacked. They say he asked to leave, but the end took the former radio king by surprise. His replacement's another shock, Ashley Bradnam.
Jamie Dunn's listeners had no idea this morning's 4BC brekkie show was to be his last.
All right, we're done for the weekend. We'll see you Monday.
Yes.
Next Tuesday, I'm thinking of doing Ranga Radio and just having redheads. I'm not sure.
Oh, that's an idea.
It's an idea.
But the on-air light dimmed for good for the likeable Dunn within minutes.
Possibly they took the opportunity to enact a see you later clause.
It apparently came after Jamie Dunn and his on-air sidekick Ian Calder approached station management for a pay rise, an extra $2,000 each, according to Dunn. Not per week, but per year.
You know, and then you sit down and say, well, thanks a lot, but, you know, $10 a day is too much. See ya.
We're actually talking about a new agreement. We just couldn't reach agreement, unfortunately.
Station boss David McDonald says it wasn't money or the breakfast show's sagging ratings which raised the stakes.
Jamie came to me earlier this week and said he had another deal on the table and another offer.
And 4BC listeners may get another shock from their new brekkie jock, with Nova's ex, Ashley Bradnam, bouncing back on air.
Well, I guess the biggest difference is I'm sober now.
Bradnam's last gig in the media wasn't a happy one, with a drink driving conviction and an 18-month loss of licence.
I can't wait to get on radio on 4BC Monday at 5:30 and let it rip.
If Jamie Dunn's bitter, he's hiding it beautifully. In fact, this weekend he's off in a completely different direction, with a small role in an 8-minute film. The film's called True Love.
I play a murderer, and I think this is the good weekend for me to play a murderer. I think I'm going to do that one real well.
And he says his radio days are definitely not over and promises to be back very soon. Tim Collins, 10 News.